Okay, see here, we are going to see now sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Okay, figure is given, triangle ABC is given here. Okay, what we have to prove? Sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Okay, so from that we can write given triangle ABC. Triangle ABC is given. Okay, what we have to prove? To prove sum of any two sides, so AB plus AC is greater than BC. Okay, so in to prove it will come AB plus AC is greater than BC. Sum of these two sides, any sides we can take these two sides or these two sides. Okay, sum of I have taken this AB plus AC is greater than BC. Okay, so this is our target. This we are going to prove. Now directly we cannot prove, so we need to do some construction here. Okay, so we need to produce BA. We need to produce BA to point D such that this AD and AC will be equal. Okay, like that construction we need to do. So this BA I am producing. Okay, this distance means AD and this AC, whatever distance is there, that the same distance we will use for this. Okay, so point D is here. Okay, and finally we can join this D and C, point D and C. Okay, so here one thing you will get, that is AD is equal to AC. AD and AC is equal. So construction, in construction, produce BA 2D, BA 2D such that AC is equal to AD. AC is equal to AD. AC and AD are equal. Okay, like that we need to produce BA. Okay, got it everybody? So suppose I will see here angle 1, this is angle 1 and this is angle 2. Angle 1 and angle 2, angle 1 and angle 2 are same because AD and AC are equal. So angles opposite of equal sides are always same. So in proof we can mention that first. Here what is given? AC in triangle ACD, in triangle ACD, AC is equal to AD. AC is equal to AD by construction. Okay, by construction AC and AD are equal. So we can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Angle 1 and angle 2 are equals. What is the reason? Angles opposite of equal sides. Angles opposite of equal sides. Okay, so sides are angles are equal. Now after that what we can say, see here, if angle 1 and angle 2 are equal, but angle 1 is the part of angle C. Angle 1 is the part of angle C. So definitely angle C means this whole angle. Angle C is greater than angle 1. Okay? Why, got it everybody? So angle C and angle 1. Angle 1 is the part of angle C. Angle 1 is the part of angle C. Okay? So definitely angle C, whole angle C. Angle C is greater than angle 1. Okay, so we can write here angle C is greater than angle 1 because angle 1 is the part of angle C. Okay, and whole is always greater than the part. Whole is always greater than the part. Okay, so now angle C is greater than angle 1. So same thing we can write, angle C is greater than angle 2. Angle C is greater than angle 2 because angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. So suppose this is, I will say this is first one. So we can write here from first. If angle C is greater than angle 1, then we can write angle C is greater than angle 2. Angle C is greater than angle 2. Okay. So if you think about angle D and angle C, angle C is greater. Angle C is greater than angle D. Okay. Angle C is greater than angle D. Okay, if we are thinking about whole triangle now, if you are thinking about triangle BCD, angle C is greater than angle 2. Okay, angle C is greater than angle 2, that we have done. Okay, so we know that the side opposite of greatest angle, okay, here angle 2 and angle C, C is greater, so definitely BD is greater than BC. Okay, BD is greater than BC because side opposite of greater angle is always greater. Understood? So here we can mention that I am taking here angle C is greater than angle 2, so we can write BD is greater than BC. BD, because BD is the side which is opposite of angle C, and angle C is greater. Angle C is greater than angle 2. Okay, so BD is greater than BC. Okay, so why? Because side, we can write greatest side opposite to it. Okay, so this angle is greater, so this side is greater than this side, BC. Okay, so but we know that BD, this is B, this point is B. BD is greater than BC, but BD means what? BA plus AD. BD means what? BD means BA plus AC. The sum of these two, this side and this side, is equal to BD. Okay, so BD, we can write BA plus AC is greater than BC. BA plus AD is greater than BC. BD is what? BA plus AD. But AD is equal to AC. AD and AC are equal. So instead of AD, we can write BA plus AC is greater than BC. BA plus AC is greater than BC. Okay, so this was the target. BA means AB plus AC is greater than BC. Okay, so that proof here we have given. Means what we can understand? The sum of any two sides is always greater than the third side. Okay, any two sides, then only that construction of that triangle is possible. Okay. Okay, see here the second theorem from the inequalities of triangle. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, the longer side has greater angle opposite to it. Okay, so this is the given statement. Now see, once again here triangle is given, triangle ABC is given. First, if two sides of triangle are unequal, okay. So here three sides of triangles are given. So from that I am saying here AC is greater than AB. Okay, in what is given? Triangle ABC. In that AC is greater than AB. Okay, any two sides we can take. AC is greater than BC also we can take. Or AC is greater than AB, or BC is greater than AB. Anyhow, I have taken AC is greater than AB. Okay, so these two sides are unequal. Greater than means both sides are unequal. In triangle ABC, AC is greater than AB. Okay, so this is half statement. Now see, remaining, the longer side has greater angle opposite to it. Longer side has. Okay, we have taken these two sides. So this is the longer side. AC we have taken greater. So opposite of AC, which angle is coming? B. And opposite of AB, which is shorter side we have taken, opposite of that is coming angle C. So we can say we have to prove angle ABC is greater than AC. Angle ABC is greater than angle AC. We have to prove. Okay. So directly we cannot prove. We need to do some construction. Okay. So what construction we are going to do? We are going to take a point on AC. Okay. We are going to take a point on AC. We will say D point. Okay, how we are going to take whatever distance of AB, the same distance we are going to take on that. Okay, so whatever distance of AB we have taken, the same distance we will use on AC. Okay, so that point will be point D. So construction I am doing here. Okay, so that point is D. This point is D. Okay, so let's say here this angle is 1 and this angle is 2. Okay, now we have done construction AB and AD are equal. Okay, AB and AD are equal. So definitely triangle ABD is an isosceles triangle. Okay, so angle 1 and angle 2 are same. Angle 2, 1 and 2 are same because angles opposite of equal sides are same. So now construction we need to mention here. Construction. Okay. Take point D on AC such that AB is equal to AD. AB and AD are equal. Okay. So construction we have done, we have taken here also. Now we will think about the proof. Now we will think about the proof. Okay. So now in triangle ABD, first we will think about in triangle ABD, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. Okay, angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. Okay, so AB is equal to AD. If you want, you can mention that also. AB in triangle ABD, AB is equal to AD. So we can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Angle 1 we have taken this much only. This much only angle 1. Okay. Means ABD, that is angle 1. Okay. So angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So what is the reason behind this? Angles opposite of equal sides. Okay. Now if you observe here, see carefully, if you observe the figure, we can write something about angle 2. Okay. Due to BD, the triangle is divided into two triangles. In that angle 2 is the exterior angle of triangle BCD. Okay. Angle 2 is the exterior angle of BCD. Okay. So that I am taking now. Now we will think about in triangle BCD, angle 2 is the exterior angle, and we know the property of exterior angle is equal to the sum of interior opposite angle. Okay, so angle 2 we can write, angle 2 is equal to angle DCB plus angle DBC. Okay, according to the exterior angle property, exterior angle is always equal to the sum of interior opposite angle. So this is exterior angle of triangle BCD. So this is equal to the sum of this and this, which are interior opposite angles. Okay, so the sum of this, so we can write angle 2 is greater than angle DC. Okay, see here, angle 2 is sum of these two. So definitely angle 2 is greater than each of them. Okay, angle 2 is greater than this, or angle 2 is greater than this also, we can say. Understood? So here I have taken angle 2 is greater than DCB. Okay, this only if I will take this angle, so definitely angle 2 is greater than this angle DCB. Okay, so angle DCB I can write ACB also. Okay, because here angle is important, so instead of DCB I can write ACB. So I am taking here angle 2 is greater than ACB, this is, I am saying, second one. Okay, this is, you will say, this is first one. Angle 2 is greater than angle ACB. Okay, so now from first and second we can say, from 1 and 2 we can say angle 1, okay, angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. So instead of angle 2, I can replace here angle 1. Angle 1 is greater than angle AC. Angle 1, this angle, angle 1 is greater than angle ACE. Okay, angle 1, this angle 1 is greater than angle ACE. Okay, so definitely angle ABC is greater than angle ACE because angle 1 is the part of angle ABC. Okay, so here if you want, you can mention angle, but angle 1 is the part of angle ABC. Angle 1 is the part of angle ABC. Okay, so definitely I can say here angle ABC is greater than AC. So angle ABC is greater than angle AC. That would be our target. Okay, so hence the proof. What did you find? Okay, see here we are going to see now converse of theorem number 1. Okay, just like we have seen theorem number 1, now we are going to see converse of that theorem. Okay, so what is the statement given? See, in a triangle, the greater angle has the longer side opposite to it. Okay, in a triangle, the greater angle has the longer side opposite to it. Okay, so now first, given triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, greater angle has the longer side opposite to it. So in theorem number 1, we have told angle ABC is greater than angle AC. The same figure we are going to use. We told angle ABC is greater than angle AC. Okay, so same thing we are going to use here. Angle ABC is greater than angle AC. Okay, so this is given thing. We are going to use this. Okay, so ABC is greater than angle AC. Now, to prove, what we have to prove? The greater angle has the longer side opposite to it. We said here angle B is greater. So AC is greater than AB. Okay. Two angles we are going to use, angle B and angle C. From that, angle B is the greater angle. So definitely AC is the greatest side and opposite of angle C, which side is coming? AB. So AC is greater than AB. So that I am making here AC is greater than AB. Okay, that is our target that we are going to put. Understood? So now here if construction is not necessary, directly we can use, that is proof. In triangle ABC, there are three possibilities. Three possibilities. Which three possibilities? Here about when AB and AC is, we are thinking about that both sides, AB and AC. Okay, so first possibility is if AB is equal to AC. In second case, if AB is equal to AC, or you can write AC and AB are equal anyhow. Okay, if AC is smaller than AB, and third one, when AC is greater than AB. Okay, three conditions are going to come. Okay, possibilities are going to come. So first, in proof, we will think about first case, case number one. Case one, that is when AC is equal to AB. When AC is equal to AB. Think about when AC and AB are equal. AC and AB are equal. That time, what is going to come? If these two sides are equal, triangle ABC is an isosceles. In that case, triangle ABC will be an isosceles triangle. Okay. If it is an isosceles triangle, base angles are going to come same. So when AC is equal to AB, that time angle ABC is equal to angle ACB. Why? Angles opposite of equal sides. Equal sides are always equal. Angles opposite of equal sides are always equal. But this, what is given? Angle ABC is greater than ACB. But according to that, both the angles are getting same. Both the angles are getting same. So we can write this contradicts. This contradicts the given hypothesis. Given hypothesis. Given hypothesis. So AC is not equal to AB. AC and AB are not equal. Okay, so that we can write. Okay, so here we can write AC is not equal to AB. AC and AB are not equal. Okay, now we will think about second. Case number 2. What is case number 2? Case second, that is AC is smaller than AB. AC is smaller than AB. Okay, we have to prove AC is greater than AB. Okay, now in this condition, we will see whether this is satisfying the given hypothesis or not. Okay, so when AC is greater than AB, AC is greater than AB. Two sides we are thinking. If this side is greater, the angle opposite of longer side is always greater. So according to this angle, according to this, if AC is smaller than, AC is smaller than AB, that time AB is greater. AB is greater than the AC. So if AB is greater, angle C is greater than angle B. Angle C is greater than angle B. So I am taking accordingly angle ACB is, angle ACB is greater than angle ABC. Okay, but this also contradicts with the given hypothesis. Okay, angle ACB is greater than angle ABC according to this. Okay, but here ABC is greater than ACB. ABC is greater than ACB. So this also contradicts. This contradicts with given hypothesis. Given hypothesis. Okay, that is, what is hypothesis is given? Angle ABC is greater than AC. Okay, so this is also not satisfying the given condition. Okay, so definitely third one is going to satisfy. Okay, if you want, you can write the explanation, otherwise directly also we can write. So third case is AC is greater than AB, so this is must be satisfied the given hypothesis. Okay, but we will see case 3. What is case 3? When AC is greater than AB. Okay, AC greater than AB. Understood? Here we need to write reason. What is the reason you will write? Here reason, longer side, angle opposite of longer side is always greater. Okay, angle opposite of longer side is always greater. Okay, so that reason we can write. So that I am taking here, angle longer side has greater angle opposite to it. Okay, so this reason we need to write. Here also we need to write, when AC is greater than AB, this side is greater than AB. If this side is greater, AC is greater, angle opposite of that is angle B, means angle ABC. So from this we can write, angle ABC is greater than angle AC. And this is satisfying the given hypothesis. Okay, so we can write, this satisfies the given hypothesis. Okay, so here also we need to write reason, longer side has greatest angle opposite to it. Okay, so accordingly we have taken ABC is greater than AC, and this satisfies the given hypothesis. So AC is greater than AB. AC is greater than AB. Okay, so this is the converse of theorem number one. Okay, so today we have seen three theorems. So do practice and solve the same theorem in your notebook. Okay, and the same theorems you have to do in the PS period. You have to do the practice in PS period also.